things. So, welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. I've come back here again, and as soon as I entered the inn last time, I got a quest for me to complete, which is basically delivering a vial of blessed water to the Order of the Knights. That's basically a temple. So I'll just go ahead and quickly do that for 108 gold pieces. That's quite the significant amount. Anyway, so once I get done doing that, I'll be going over to the Mage's Guild and getting around 10 health potions or so, and selling all the stuff that I accumulated and amassed on my last dungeon run through, and then we'll be getting back to the dungeon. So most probably you'll just I'll just be cutting over to the dungeon the next time you see me. So yeah, so with that being said, let's go on and get this done. Alright guys, so we are now back at Stonekeep, and hopefully we'll find the Elder Scrolls this time around, wherever it is. So the last time around we actually went here, in this area, and since there was a locked door here, I don't really think the Elder Scrolls are, the Elder Scroll rather, is over here, since mission objectives don't really exist beyond locked doors in this game. They are supposed to be in areas which you can access without having to pick doors. So one area which we did not check was this area here. So I might actually go there and try and find out where the Elder Scrolls are, and hopefully Elder Scroll is, and hopefully we'll find the Elder Scroll here. And yeah, apart from that, in the last video I got some loot. I got like a plate helm, which I wanted to sell. The rest of the things didn't really fetch me much money, but what I did get from the last playthrough is the steel helm of speed. Now, while I don't know whether this is better than the silver helm in matters of defense, in terms of defense, but it will increase my speed, which will actually make it harder to get hit, harder for me to get hit. So I guess it's a trade-off which works out, I suppose. Anyway, this guy still looks badass, so I mean the steel silver helm was a little out of place with this guy. So yeah, and I went on to the delivery mission and I thought my game had bugged out again, like from that video where we had to, you know, fetch a contract from one place and deliver it to another, but it was, the contract was in a completely different store. I thought it was going to do that again, and I initially thought that, you know, I don't exactly have the time for this, so I decided to skip it. But then the 108 gold in the deal sort of got me interested in, wait, you know what, I mean, it's gonna take me, how much time is it gonna take me, like 1 hour or so. So I decided, you know what, let's just go ahead and do that. And it turns out I had been looking at this one, even though the date was a dead giveaway that, you know, something was off. I visited a few of these places, a few of the temples. Luckily it was a temple, not one of those stores that would have taken me ages otherwise. But yeah, and in one of those stores I just took out the journal and I realized that I had been reading it the wrong way around. I actually, the latest you know, tasks, they get added to the end of the journal instead of on the top. So this was basically where we had to go, and I went there and I got it. So yeah, that was only the one time that I found any bugs with the game, so I suppose that was good. Let me just increase the volume here for a moment. Yeah, I suppose that should make it. And I can hear skeevers already. Wait, let me just make sure that I have my katana equipped. Yeah, I do. And I also like bought a daikatana and gave my broadsword over for repairs, since, you know, I've been using it for a long time, it won't exactly hurt me to repair it. And I've also got 10 potions of healing this time, so those should come in handy. If not here, then in the next dungeon. And I don't really think I need more potions, but whatever. So that was a screen right here. Here we go. Die. Anybody else wants to come and take a swing? I can hear mice. Ah, right here. Hmm. Anybody else wants to challenge me? I think the door should be right here. Right here, yeah. So let's just check these rooms one by one. I mean, there could be loot behind these doors, so that's pretty much... look at this. That's pretty much how I found the plate helm of speed the last time around, so I'm not exactly gonna ignore these. Or I think I found it off an enemy. I don't exactly remember. It's been a few days since I played this game. And I think somebody else came out. Yeah, goblins. I can hear goblins. And another door just opened. Nothing here, so... Right, look at this guy. One hit kills. I mean, that's what I really like about the katana. The katana. Only one hit kills. You just need one hit. This lock seems relatively easy, so let me go ahead and pilfer this.
3 hours later.
Fail. You know what? Let's just bash this door using a daikatana. I don't really want to use the daikatana as my primary weapon because it is a two-handed weapon. So you see all the negative numbers, they just disappeared. I mean, with the katana and the tower shield, look at this. I get so much more bonus to defense, but with the daikatana they all just disappear. I mean, I don't think I exactly want to sacrifice my defense. Look at this, one hit and we're done. So let's just quickly switch back over to our katana and our tower shield. Yep, look at all those negative numbers. So yeah, basically I don't exactly want to lose my defense for more offense. Another locked door. Okay. Nothing here? Okay, fine. Oh shit, these are wolves. Let me just get up here real quick. Let's see if they can reach me here. I think I'm gonna hold on to the daikatana for the time being because, well... they certainly can. See, this game has that D&D logic of, you know, being surrounded and being being flanked and being surrounded by multiple enemies, because as soon as there were three wolves, the hit rate greatly increased, and of course they've got nothing usable. So their hit rate greatly increased, and my health started dropping faster than if it was just one wolf. So let's try this place here. Okay. Anything here? Nothing. Okay, this one was open. And would you look at that? I think this is the way to go. I mean, none of the other rooms added. Let's see. I mean, if we do get the Elder Scrolls quite early on, I might just explore a little bit before I decide to, get out of this dungeon. So you can actually jump in this game. You've got to hold left click and right click in order to jump. Or right click and left click, I don't exactly remember. Or you could just use the J key. So, yeah. I can't jump onto it. That is a little strange. I guess I'll try from here. Let's just put the sword in and try. Yeah. So basically I need the sword in. And... okay. Alright guys, so I actually went online and checked, and apparently we can jump forward using the shift key and the jump key, which is J. So let me just give that a quick check if we can do that, and it should be successful if we can. So I'm just gonna hold on shift here and J. Oof. We did it. See, these are the things which the game does not tell you. I mean, in these older games, if you had a manual, I mean, they came with manuals, so there was practically no other way to know this stuff except for if you were using manuals. So, oh, skeleton? Oh my god, these guys are strong. Yep, these guys are super strong. I'm gonna have to use a potion right now. In a while. Yeah, I'm just gonna use a potion of healing real quick. Just that much? Really? Come on, you can heal. Yeah, that's it. There we go. So, yeah, so back in the original games, a staff, okay, that's 3 gold there. Another staff, that's another 3 gold there. Nothing usable. Did I loot this guy? Could I loot this guy? Again, another skeleton. 3? How many are there? Okay, I better back up here. Oh shit. Just laying down corpses of the undead here. So many skeletons, my god. Well, this better be the final battle. Because if it isn't, if there are stronger enemies here, then I'm seriously not gonna be able to survive this. 30 gold pieces, nice. A dagger, that's 1 gold. So yeah, like I was saying, in these older games, most of the information that you used to get was by the way of manuals, and this game, it did not come with a manual. You just have to go online and figure stuff out on your own. Because if you don't, then you're stuck here like I am. So another potion of healing, how many potions is that? So I think we should have around 6 left. Let's see. Yep, 6 potions of healing. That was rough, to say the least. Is that loot? Is that loot? I don't know, I mean, it looks like loot, but I don't think... I guess it's not. Anyway, so... I guess this is a platform right here, which we can use to go to this place. And I suppose that looks like somewhere where we want to go, so... Do we want to get in the water right here? I guess we do. Let's go. But man, this skeleton fight was rough. We should be able to get up right here. So, yeah. That's cool. I can see something. What are these things? Ghouls? That was a heavy hit. I'm just gonna go ahead and heal up real quick. Even the healing has got like a randomized effect here, like much like it would in D&D. So, I mean, it's all a product of chance. I am now diseased. Great. Yep, time to use another potion of healing here. Would you mind hitting him? I swear, the next time I get points, I'm gonna pour all of them, or at least almost all of them, into agility, because, man, it's super difficult to hit some of these guys. See, just on cue. How many points do we have? 5 to agility it is then. Nah, 6 to... Or... Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave that at 60 and I'm gonna pour these 2 points into here. I feel like I've got what matters quite like well upgraded right here, like strength and well agility at this point. So and endurance. So I think I'm just gonna pour the rest of it into speed and luck. I don't really think intelligence matters that much as a warrior and perception, I guess. So, I mean, perception is fairly high, I wouldn't really know, but I guess it is. And, yeah, willpower, we need to increase that, because that is basically what saves us from... Yeah, these are ghouls. I mean, I could recognize it from the sound of them, and I didn't know ghouls carried gold, but anyway. 58 gold pieces and a short bow, which I'm gonna sell because I can't equip that since I'm a warrior. So let's just save quickly here. And I hope I don't run into any more ghouls. I did. Just as I said that. This is nothing, just a showpiece. Oh shit. So guys, 10 potions of healing are not going to cut it for this. Well, that was still fairly quick. 8 gold pieces from this ghoul. That is a nice little statue there. And I think I'm gonna top up with another health potion right now. What was that? Man, like seriously. Oh shit, I'm getting slaughtered out here. Yeah, 10 health potions do not cut it. Like seriously, these guys are tough. And they hit hard. Just look at this guy. As well equipped as I am, man, I'm having some real trouble, actually. I can't get the other guy, so... A mark, whatever that is. I'm just gonna use another potion of healing right now. And there are more around me. So... Let's see here. The short bow, the mark, just one more potion of healing. This is gonna be rough. This is going to be really rough. I mean, I should probably run the next time I see them, but yeah. I don't know what this is. This looks like a tablet of some sort. I know the Elder Scrolls is in there. The Elder Scroll is in there. And it has got a chest. Cool. So, what do you got? Bag of 91 gold pieces. Oh shit. Well mate, you better die quickly and not really... Look at this. Just look at this. With all the equipment I have as a warrior, this guy is ripping me apart. Man, I hope I can make it. Like, really. And I hope that was the last of them, because this is... And a longsword, thank you. I could probably use that. And if it is magical, then all the better. I know I shouldn't be bashing with my Daikatana, but yeah, I don't exactly want to... And a short sword. Wow, there's a lot of loot here. So I guess that was sort of worth it in the end. And yeah, so this is what we came for, so we'll just backtrack our steps and exit the way we leave, because I don't want to face any of these other ghouls anymore. And more minotaurs, those people will rip me apart. Anyway, so time to leave, I guess. And yeah, so this game actually has a bug. Now, right here, I picked up the parchment, which is basically the Elder Scroll, which Queen Bloombaka will use to decipher the location of the Elder Scroll for me. However, yeah, so basically what they used is a prefab game item, like quest item, and they used a counter, I suppose. I haven't looked at the source code. I guess this was built on assembly, so I don't really know. Anyway, so... the bug of the game is if you basically exit Stonekeep and come back here and pick up the same Elder Scroll again, then they will be, you know, you would actually get the next quest item that you have to get, which is the one of the pieces of the Elder Scroll which we will be getting from Fanglir. So, I mean, a quick way to actually finish this game, if you want to cheat and exploit the bug, is just to keep coming back to Stonekeep, and you'll keep leveling up and keep picking up this Elder Scroll, and that way you can actually, you know, like, complete the game without having to face monsters of greater difficulty, or just pointlessly go and explore more dungeons. But that isn't exactly the way you're meant supposed to be playing this game. So yeah, there you have it, and we shall now head back, right back. I'm just gonna ignore every single of these things that I run into, because I do not have any health potions for them. And I guess that was all of the ghouls, because I can't exactly hear them anymore. Oh shit. Calm down, son. Calm down. I guess our entrance was from here? Or was it from here? Shit, I can't even remember at this point. Wait. Let me just check. Ah, yes, the jumping place was here. And... should we? I mean, if we see some monsters, we'll just, you know, get the fuck out of here. But yeah, until that time, I guess we could just explore this area a bit. Don't get stuck on the walls, son. Look at this. Would you just look at this? And I got a talk, which I should be able to use. I don't know what talks to... Oh, look at this. Longsword is actually blessed. Oh my god, look at the boost which it gave me. Like, man, I don't know what this mark did, but yeah. This talk, just look at the jump to the boost. -2 to everything. And the amulet, wow. Okay, so I think I better save now. I'm just gonna save here, and... more loot. Let's just drop a few things. I don't really think so. We could drop this thing here. Yeah, the longsword is slightly used, so it won't really fetch me that much money, except for this one. Might just be the difference between, you know, going broke and living rich. So we'll just carry that, and we'll get the fuck out of here. So, climb up, and we'll just update the dungeon escape safe. Don't want any interruptions while going back, now do we? Man, like, I have to tell you, man, like, 10 health potions and it barely cut it. Alright, goblin, time to kill you. I can take on a goblin, no problem with that. And we got a stuff, so another goblin. Really? You guys come out now, after I've killed all those ghouls? Seriously? Time to get out of here. Whew, we made it. Boy, that was stressful. But hey, at least we made it in the end, didn't we? Of course it's night. Of course it's night. So we're just gonna go ahead and save here. We're going the wrong way. We'll just go this way instead. What, a ghoul over here? Hell no, I ain't fighting that thing. Visitor. Let me in. Oof. Finally. Man, never have I ever been so thankful to have a safe haven like this inn right here. Man, this game is like super difficult. Really. I mean, this place just continues having some of the other quests for me. Obsidian skull I have was supposed to be at the red boat yesterday, and if it ain't there by Sundas 20th of first seed, things could get real nasty. Someone there will give you a reward if you're at red boat on time. Do we have a deal? Sure. Dragon's teeth. The good spirits must have delivered you in that. Indeed, I'm relying on your Grimfangs to not let me down. I think we owe a drink after that. Or even two. Eight, please. Yep, I am. I mean, you guys suck at bargaining, but I guess I'm lucky. So let's just go ahead and camp anywhere. And what's the time right now? 7:10 in the evening, so that means 5 hours till 12 o'clock and 6 hours till the morning. Well, let's just make it 7. So I guess we'll be resting for 12 hours then. Alright, humans, so I basically completed all the side things which I had to do. I completed the side quest, and oh, hello there, so many people around me. I feel popular all of a sudden. I guess I did help them out quite a bit, so anyway. So I basically did a lot of side stuff. I didn't really get much to sell this time around, but I did get a lot of loot, which I could carry with me. So as we can see here, we got 2645 gold with us. And Yeah, I basically sold Longsword of Luck because... I just didn't see myself using it. I mean, it is useful if you want to, like, find better loot, I suppose, in the loot caches and all the, you know, discarded items and stuff. But apart from that, I didn't really see much of a point to actually carrying around the Longsword of Luck, because it doesn't really give me much of a boost in actual combat. Plus, it weighs 8 kilos, so that's, that's a lot of weight which I can use for other stuff. So, I'm yet to deliver the Elder Scroll back to Queen Lubanka. I completed the side mission which I was given, and yeah, I suppose that's about it. I'm yet to get cured. I have leprosy from my last raid, and yeah, that's it. So let's go ahead and deliver the Elder Scroll. You've recovered the parchment. I hope you put Gualthog into an early grave as well. Not really, I mean, we never really encounter him in the game. Unless he's one of the ghouls, I don't really know. Still, I will complete my end of the bargain. Queen Lubanka motions to a courier, who respectfully bows and brings forward a pen. Staring intently at the parchment, the queen takes a few moments and then inscribes the location of Anglair. Somewhere in the province of Hammerfall onto your map. That's the beauty of these things, the Elder Scrolls games. You never know what the Elder Scrolls actually can prophesize or foretell, or basically what they can tell you. I don't know whether it would be something as banal as the location of Anglair, but I mean, it is my prophecy as written in the Elder Scrolls, so I think Queen Lubanka can pretty much sacrifice a bit of a sight to help me fulfill my prophecy. And now we're off. It's best not to explore much in these areas, for reasons I have already told you before. And I suppose this is where this video ends. The next time we come along... our next video is gonna take quite a long time, because I've decided... I mean, with the way that I just burned through all my health potions, like I had to use 10 health potions just to get the Elder Scroll back, and yeah, that was rough. I mean, that was really rough. So in light of that, I have actually decided that I need to go back to Stonekeep and keep grinding with health potions, of course, until I have got enough money to purchase like 100 health potions. So the next video is probably gonna be a little late, so let's see when I can release it. Pretty sure it's not really gonna take more than a week, I suppose, but yeah, it might be a wait. So, until next time, catch you guys later, take care.